Redskins trying to lead the Vikings today to their fourth consecutive victory. So it's the Vikings and the Redskins. Welcome, everyone. Dick Stockton along with John Lynch. And, of course, the big story is RG3. And the question is, how efficient a quarterback will he be today?
Well, first of all, I think it's important to talk about his health. He's been through a litany of tests, Dick. He has been tested every day since that injury occurred. He's passed it with flying colors. He looked at us and said, Dick, John, I have no symptoms. I'm being honest about that. With that being said, Mike Shanahan says we're putting our full offense out there. And what that offense has been, led by RG3, is first of all a brilliant running game led by Robert Griffin III. You have to account for him because of his world-class speed, because of his athleticism. Now, what surprised me and so many is his proficiency as a passer. He's leading the league as a 69% passer. His challenge today is a really tough Minnesota defense.
Boy, the Vikings certainly one of the surprise teams of the league, John. So how have they accomplished it and what must they do today against the Redskins?
Well, first of all, who thunk it? I mean, people had these guys at the bottom of the league, and I think Leslie Frazier has done a tremendous job leading this team and helping them find their identity, who they are, and who that is a football team that we said in the open, led by a stifling and swarming defense led by Jared Allen. And then on the offense, they ride their two stars in Adrian Peterson and Percy Harvin, as good as it gets at their positions in the NFL. An emerging star, they feel, in Christian Ponder at the quarterback position.
Should be good. And the Redskins going against the Vikings, and Leslie Frazier, 10-7 as a career head coach, second year, full year as coach, and his first victory as an interim coach was right here against these Redskins. And Mike Shanahan in his third year as head coach. And you know, he's all about the running game. In fact, both of these teams emphasize pounding the ball. So it'll be interesting to see if they go off that a little bit in this game, John.
And they both do it well.
Percy Harvin will return the opening kick. Redskins won the toss and they deferred. It'll go out of the end zone. And the Vikings will start from the 20-yard line. Christian Ponder. And talked about his completion percentage, second in the league, and has thrown only two interceptions, and both last week.
And they don't ask a ton out of Christian Ponder, but he's playing just how they want him to play. He's not beating the Vikings. He's getting the ball in the hands of his stars, namely Adrian Peterson and Percy Harvin.
First down from the 20. Play action. Ponder is going to run and will go out of bounds after picking up maybe a yard or so. And you talk about some of the marquee impact players on offense for this Viking team.
And we talked about a couple of them already. We'll see them early. We'll see them often. Percy Harvin, call him Slash. He's all over the field at wide receiver, at running back. They throw the ball to him on quick throws. Adrian Peterson, a motivated Adrian Peterson, emotional to the point of coming back to where he was hurt last year. And Kyle Rudolph, an emerging star at the tight end position.
Second down and 8. And they're going to run the ball to Peterson here. And the Redskins are right there. And Perry Riley making the tackle after a gain of 3. Here's the Redskin defense, and that has been the problem for them. 28th in points allowed in the league, and that's something they need to shore up.
Well, and it's so much bigger than one player, but they lost their best player, and that was Brian Arakpo earlier in the year against the St. Louis Rams. Ryan Kerrigan's done a tremendous job of picking up the slack, but this back in, the defensive backs have been torched as a result of a lack of pass rush. We'll see if they can generate it.
Third down and 5 out of the shotgun, and the first pass to a wide open Kyle Rudolph, and a first down for the Vikings, and a gain of 18.
We're going to watch Kyle Rudolph run a corner route here. One of the things Christian Ponder said is that the Redskins do so many things defensively, we think they're vulnerable. You find a lot of guys wide open with no one around them, and that's the case right there. A breakdown by the Redskins early.
They call him the Vikings version of Tony Gonzalez of the Falcons. And a first down at the 43-yard line. Play action. And here's Percy Harvin. And Harvin goes out of bounds after getting another first down. Leslie Frazier telling us that we got to use Harvin even if he isn't the focal point. Teams have to watch him.
Well, and watch how they use him. They're going to line him up, bring him in motion, and then he's going to come across the formation get the ball in his hands. That's the important thing because he's so special with the ball in his hands. A running back playing the wide receiver position. This guy may be the best player in football right now.
And the Vikings use the word dynamic when they talk about Harvin. Gain of 15 into Redskin territory. Here is Peterson. And again, the breaks a tackle. And Peterson down the sideline. Inside the 20-yard line. Redskins had several shots on him, and he ends up picking up 32 yards before Medeo Williams makes the play on him.
And you think he's tackled, but not so fast. Watch Adrian Peterson keeping the legs churning, the vision, and then the all-out will, refusing to go down. Dick, you saw it in the meeting. We sat down with him the other day. After being injured here, you had the feeling he wanted to have a special day and a great start.
And what a great work ethic to get back into action. Gets the call here, and Peterson still on his feet. He has made two tough runs and gets to the 5-yard line where Josh Wilson making the tackle. Second and goal coming up.
Dick, I'll just ask you, does that look like a guy who tore his ACL less than 10 months or 10 months and change ago?
Not at all. And he said 5 months into it, he said, I knew that I was going to make it and be ready for the season.
And the scary thing for opposing defenses, he says, I'm still not 100%.
Toby Gerhardt has replaced Peterson, who has gained 40 yards on his first three carries. Second and goal, Ponder's pass up the middle, and it's incomplete, intended for Devin Aromashadu, former Chicago Bear. Third and goal coming up. Vikings impressive on their first possession of the game after Redskins deferred. They have scored on all 15 of their red zone possessions this year.
And if I'm the Washington Redskins, I'm locating Kyle Rudolph. Christian Ponder loves his tight end down here.
Ponder chased from the pocket in trouble, and the pass is caught by Gerhardt at the 2-yard line. It'll bring up fourth down and goal. And Leslie Frazier, not taking any chances, brings his field goal team on. So Blair Walsh, and what a leg he has. He is 3 for 3 this year from beyond 50. This will be a 20-yard chip shot for him, and the field goal is good, and the Vikings on the opening possession get stalled, but get 3 points out of it and lead the Redskins 3-0. What a big day on Fox today. Josh Freeman leading the Tampa Bay Buccaneers with an impressive performance against Kansas City. Sean Green leading the Jets. They scored 35 against the Colts, and a 108-yard kick return touchdown by Jacoby Jones as the Baltimore Ravens beat the Dallas Cowboys just barely.
I tell you, as we see Robert Griffin III, what a league it is this year, Dick, in that any given Sunday has never been more true than 2012 in the National Football League.
How about the Browns winning their first game of the year over Cincinnati?
Small victory for the Redskins, keeping the Vikings out of the end zone there. But one thing they're going to have to figure out, it's very obvious that Adrian Peterson and Percy Harvin is who they have to stop. Today, they didn't have an answer on that first drive, and they better find it in a hurry.
9 plays, 78 yards, and they get 3 out of it. And Peterson, who gained 32 yards on one play. Brandon Banks back deep for the Redskins, and Blair Walsh will kick it to him. You mentioned the Vikings winning 3 in a row, and an impressive win against the 49ers, and then they beat the Lions. They came back after that big win and knocked off Tennessee last week. They have already won more games this year than they did all of last season. And that will scoop by Brandon Banks, and the Redskins will start from the 20-yard lines. So RG3, talk about completion percentage, lack of interceptions, he's right there with the best of them.
He is. He's been incredibly efficient, dynamic, explosive, you name it, he's been it. The challenge is, how do you play his style of football and stay alive in this league? And And he said point blank, I've got to do a better job of protecting myself so I can be there for my team.
First down from the 20. And the pitch goes to Morris, and Morris is going to be stopped for a 5-yard loss by Antoine Winfield. Alfred Morris, the impressive rookie running back who's gone over 100 the last two games, is knocked back for the loss.
Antoine Winfield, one of the great tackling cornerbacks in the history of this league. That's right, I said it, the history of this league. And Alfred Morris does not go down easy. Antoine Winfield gets him down on first contact.
14 years of experience, and he showed why already this season for Minnesota. Loss will be 4, second and 14. And the pitch goes to Morris, and he's going to lose again. And this time it's Jared Allen, mostly known for getting to the quarterback and a loss of 3 getting to Alfred Morris.
Well, the Minnesota Vikings right now are playing in the Redskins' backfield, and they've got finishers. This is one of the best tackling defenses in the NFL, and they're showing you why early on.
Jared Allen, and he was the one who really talked about how this identity has emerged for the Vikings. Great improvement. Meanwhile, Evan Royster, number 22, has come in. And running back on 3rd and 17 against RG3. He dumps it off to Royster. And Royster's not going to even get back to the 20. Thanks to Chad Greenway. And a 7-yard gain, and that will force the Redskins to kick from about the goal line.
Dick, everybody's trying to figure out why have the Vikings been so successful this year. We've seen it on the first offensive drive, and then defensively, they make it life miserable on opposing quarterbacks. They hit Robert Griffin III right away to announce their presence.
Sav Rocca will actually kick from the 5. And Marcus Sherrills has returned a punt 77 yards. And this kick going out of bounds, it'll be great field position. Well, it was here in Washington, week 16, Christmas Eve, when Adrian Peterson tore his ACL and MCL. And he returned for the opening game of the season, off to a solid start. Very down moment. I agree with you about the emotion he showed to us yesterday about coming back.
Well, we asked him his feelings when he laid on this turf. He said, first of all, it was pain. Second of all, why me? But by the end of that day, I was already thinking about outside of the box in terms of having one of the great recoveries ever, and he is.
From the 47, here's Peterson going off the left side and gets tripped up just before he gets the first down yardage. He gets 9 yards on the play and lost his shoe in the process.
That may be the only way they slow him down, by taking his shoes. This guy, I've played against him, as tough as a back as there's ever been in this league in terms of the effort he runs with. You match that with elite physical skills, speed, power, vision. He's a wonderful football player.
While he adjusts his shoe and puts a new one on, Toby Gerhardt comes back in. Here's Harbin in motion to the slot to the right. Ponder, getting some time, goes underneath to Toby Gerhardt. And London Fletcher is right there. And a gain of 7 yards. In the game that Peterson got hurt, Gerhardt gained 109 yards rushing.
The last 2 years, I was talking to Bob Sloak, the linebacker coach for the Redskins, prior to the game. He said, not only did they have Adrian Peterson and Harvin, they bring Gerhardt off the bench, and he goes for 76 2 years ago on us, 109 last year.
Ball is at the 38, first down for the Vikings. Fake a handoff to Harvin, and here is Ponder, and Ponder drills it, and the pass is knocked down, incomplete, intended for Gerhardt, coming out of the backfield. So it'll be 2nd and 10.
One of the things the Vikings doing very effectively is not only utilize Percy Harvin with his skills, they utilize him very well as a decoy. And there was an example of it. You put the ball out to Percy Harvin, he's going to attract attention. It opens it up for everyone else.
So they always want to protect his playing time, but you got to play him more so they watch him, see where he's going. Peterson is back in the game at running back. Play action pass. Ponder completes it to Harvin. And Harvin gets inside the Redskin 15. And a pickup of 23 yards for the Vikings, who lead 3-0 and threaten again.
Well, this is the challenge that the Vikings present. You've got Adrian Peterson in the backfield. He's going to attract a lot of attention. Nice sell by Christian Ponder. He gets back in the pocket and watch Percy Harvin turn around a really good cornerback in D'Angelo Hall. Wide open. Linebackers suck up. You throw it to Harvin. Good equation.
Peterson gets hit and stopped behind the line by Reed Cowdy. And a loss of one. And right now for a game break, let's... All right, Patrick, remember New England lost to Arizona, another NFC West team. Here is Ponder, and Ponder incomplete to Rhett Ellison, the rookie tight end. And it'll be third and 12, and right now let's send it down to the third member of our team, Jennifer Hale.
Well, Dick, I spoke with Adrian Peterson before the game, and he tells me that left ankle that he rolled last week is still tender, giving him some problems this week. You can tell he's favoring it when he walks, but sure not when he plays. He says he's mentally prepared to block it out and play through the pain today. Dick?
I don't know if anyone's mentally tougher than this guy. Thank you, Jennifer. Third and 12. Ponder getting the rush, and the screen pass to Peterson, and Adrian Peterson gets tripped up just inside the 10-yard line by Keenan Robinson, the rookie linebacker from Texas. He gets 7 yards, but it sets up perhaps another chip shot for Blair Walsh.
And that's an excellent tackle by Keenan Robinson. You see Adrian Peterson with this much daylight, I'm thinking touchdown right about now, but watch Keenan Robinson going to come out of your screen. He's going to grab Adrian Peterson and get him down. Excellent play by Keenan Robinson.
And Blair Walsh with a 27-yard field goal, so he's had two kicks from 20 and 27. And the Vikings take a 6-0 lead with a little more than 6 minutes remaining in the first. Peterson has averaged nearly 9.5 yards per carry and 47 yards rushing thus far.
Not bad for a guy coming off an ACL injury and then a twisted ankle last week. He fooled me.
Talking with him yesterday, he said, you know, one thing I've learned is that I don't have to do it alone. And when the draft came and Percy Harvin was up, he said, I actually prayed that the Vikings would actually draft Harvin. He knew what it would mean to have a guy like Harvin with him as a 1-2 punch.
Yeah, and that's back in 2009, and they haven't looked back. It's been some rough years since then. 2009, as we see the scoring drive. But Brett Favre, remember in 2009, they're a snap away, a series away from getting to the Super Bowl, and then it's been about rebuilding. And this rebuilding process has really accelerated itself early in 2012.
6-0, and Brandon Banks back again for the Redskins. And Banks will down it right at the back of the end zone. Well, RG3 has taken a lot of hard hits this season.
Well, he's finding out, as we see Carlos Dunlap in Cincinnati 2 weeks ago down in Tampa, Mark Maron. And this was the one he was concussed on with Sean Weatherspoon last week. That in the NFL, there's big guys that can run. Now, he got a little irritated when I asked him about that. He said, it's still football. But yes, I do have to learn to protect myself. That's going to be an emphasis today and throughout his career.
And maybe throw the ball away more, not necessarily sliding. From the 20-yard line, play action for RG3. And will carry it out of bounds. And let's see what he picks up there, 7 yards. What a big edge in total yards, but it's 6-0, and the Redskins are just a touchdown and an extra point away from taking the lead.
And a sarcastic, or maybe not sarcastic, applause for RG3 as he ran out of bounds at the end of that play. These Redskins fans know how valuable number 10 is to them and their fortunes.
Second down and 3, and fake an end around, and going deep is Griffin, and the pass is knocked away, and Harrison Smith, the number 1 pick for the Vikings out of Notre Dame, got a hand on it on the pass intended for Leonard Ankerson.
Harrison Smith has brought something that the Vikings did not have, and that's a presence in the secondary. Watch Harrison Smith come out of your screen, attack the football. He doesn't have any interceptions, But this guy has had a big impact on this defense.
And Leslie Frazier had an apt description. He says, he's our little John Lynch.
He's not little, I promise you that. And he's having a huge impact on this Vikings defense.
Redskins have struggled on third downs. They need 3 yards here. And there is Greenway chasing Griffin, and the pass is caught. Or intercepted, it's picked off by Antoine Winfield. Winfield makes the interception.
Great job.
What a magnificent interception by Antoine Winfield. We're gonna see him undercut, left foot down, right foot down, controls the ball, left foot down, there's the right foot, then he's gonna control it all the way through, going to the ground. Wonderful play by Antoine Winfield.
And pass intended for Josh Morgan. And of course, on all turnovers, we have a review. And we will review this.
The play will not go under review. Winfield. It's interception, Minnesota, first down.
Tony Correnti, the referee today, and clean interception for Winfield.
It was a quick review because they saw what we saw, which was a phenomenal interception by Antoine Winfield.
And only the third interception of the season for the Vikings, who again have the ball in Redskin territory. First down and an end around is bobbled by Harbin. And Harbin is going to be trapped back at about the 37 and will lose a couple of yards.
Bill Musgrave, the offensive coordinator for the Minnesota Vikings, does such a tremendous job of utilizing Percy Harbin. He drops the reverse toss there. Leslie Frazier said, after going to the Senior Bowl in the Combine last year, he had so many defensive coaches around the league come up to him and say, it's so hard to defend number 12. And he went back to Bill and said, I don't care how small he is, we're playing him, and we're playing him often this year. It's resulted in more snaps and tremendous production this year.
Second and 11. And here's Peterson trying to go off to the right side. And the Redskins, led by D'Angelo Hall, loses his helmet and has a few words for AP as well. Peterson picking up a yard.
What the Redskins are trying to do is plug up the middle and make him bounce. You see Adrian Peterson, the jump cut that he's so well known for, and you see space. Well, watch D'Angelo Hall come out of nowhere and make a tremendous tackle on Adrian Peterson.
Third and 10. Ponder. And the pass is to Michael Jenkins, and Jenkins, the former Atlanta Falcon, with a 20-yard pickup. So Jerome Simpson unable to play today because of that injury, back injury, and his leg a bit numb, and they wanted to hit that deep threat, but they get Jenkins for 20.
That's just a great job by Ponder. They bring the heat. The offensive line that has played so well for the Vikings does a great job of giving him time. He finds Jenkins.
Hand off to Peterson again. And the Redskins closing down Adrian Peterson the last couple of times. Stephen Bowen making the stop. No gain, maybe a loss of one. Under 3.5 to play in the first quarter. Couple of field goals for the Vikings, and that's their lead. Toby Gerhardt checks in. Second and 11 on the 17. Ponder completes the pass to John Carlson, former Seahawk tight end, now playing for the Vikings, and he gets 7.
John Carlson's a player that they're very high on, and they want to add him into the many weapons that they have. He's had a slow start to the year, only 2 catches coming in today. That's his third. Leslie Frazier said, we want to get this guy more involved because he's been a productive player in this league, and we feel he can be productive with us.
Third down and 4. Here is Gerhardt, and Gerhardt will be stopped at the 9 by Perry Riley. So once again, Blair Walsh will come on to try a field goal.
I tell you what, the Vikings are moving the ball very well, but the Redskins are doing a great job in the red zone of buckling down, not allowing them in the end zone. See if Blair Walsh can make his third of the day.
27-yard attempt. And the Vikings take a 9-0 lead. Blair Walsh hitting a pair from 27, one from 20 yards, and it seems this entire quarter is being played in the Redskins' half of the field. Well, it's a Foxtoberfest of sports all month long tonight. The NFL on Fox.
Nick, a lot of depressed people here in Washington watching their Nationals. You got to call that game, watching the Nationals go down. And we talked to some of the players around here. They said the Cardinals a great example and never stop playing. Down 6-0, come back. Tremendous action.
Really disappointing the baseball fans, but now Redskin fans looking to finally win a game after losing 8 here in succession. Walsh will kick off to Brandon Banks. And this kick will sail out of the end zone for the touchback. Anquan Winfield with a big interception. For more, well, let's go down to Jen Hall.
Well, you know, Dick, 35-year-old cornerback Anquan Winfield certainly did not mince words after the Vikings lost to the Colts in September. He gave a fiery speech to this Vikings squad. He told me he didn't want to see this young team make some of the same mistakes he sees in himself during his early years. Mainly that he didn't take games seriously enough and didn't respect how hard it is to win in the NFL. Instead, he says he just relied on his athletic abilities. Winfield told me he wanted to teach those following in his footsteps the importance of preparation and finishing games. Dick?
All right, thank you very much. A hail and hearty report by Jennifer Hale, and a 4-yard gain by Alfred Morris. So Winfield, of course, has also played a big role off the field this season.
Yeah, he has. Jen just talked about the inspired speech. And Adrian Peterson, when we asked him what's the difference, he said, listen, we were scuffling early. After Indy, he talked to us. He said he doesn't say much. When he does, he means it. And it's obviously lifted this team to the success they're having.
And there's the pass on the slant to Fred Davis. Tight end and a first down at the 38-yard line. Davis, the leading receiver after the first 5 games for the Redskins. Tackled by Chris Cook.
Well, Alfred Morris and RG3 have been such great run threats. Again, the play action so effective. You see Chad Greenway eat the play action fake, provide space for Fred Davis. A good, accurate throw by RG3. Nice execution by the Redskins.
And a gain of 15. And the handoff is to Morris, who is a 6th-round pick out of Florida Atlantic University. And talking about why it was FAU, he said originally he thought he might end up in West Virginia as a fullback.
As a linebacker,
right?
Actually, he played fullback at FAU, but he thought he'd end up at West Virginia. His mom told him, pray about it, and they were the last ones to give him a Division I offer, and here he is playing for his favorite team. He became a Redskin fan. Brandon Banks, a wide receiver, lined up in the backfield.
2nd and 7. RG3 completes to Fred Davis again. So a similar slant pass to the tight end. And that gets 16 yards as the Redskins into Viking territory. And that will end the first quarter here.
That's the exact same play. One thing I know about Mike Shanahan, having played for him for 4 seasons, if something's working, go right back to it. It's the exact same play. Again, the play action. A lot of space for Fred Davis. First down, Redskins.
America's Game of the Week will return after these messages and a word from your local Fox station. First play of the 2nd quarter, and a pitch to Brandon Banks. Loses a yard thanks to Anquan Winfield. Dick Stockton along with John Lynch and Jennifer Hale. Vikings leading 9-0, and the Redskins need a good possession here offensively to keep their defense off the field.
Yeah, a couple 3-and-outs for the Redskins. The Vikings driving at will and then not being able to get in the end zone. That's the only thing that has this game as close as it is.
2nd down and 11. Redskins in Viking territory. And a The handoff is to Morris, and Morris is tackled by Aaron Henderson for a game break. Let's check in again with Patrick
O'Donnell. Back to you.
It is a big win for Detroit, needing it in a division in which the Vikings and the Bears have taken hold. And there is the pitch inside to Santana Moss. So they're trying everything. Brandon Banks and now Moss. Kevin Williams is there to make the tackle after a gain of five.
And this is the money down right now where the Redskins have been struggling this year. Their offense has been extremely productive. They've been running it well. They've been throwing it well. Third down has been their nemesis. It hurt them mightily last week versus the Atlanta Falcons when they were only 1 for 9. They've worked on it a lot this week.
And it's fourth down and three, trailing 9-0. And the Redskins going for it. We've seen some razzle-dazzle from Kyle Shanahan thus far. Fourth and three, here is RG3, and his pass will be caught by Santana Moss, and a first down for the Redskins. 6-yard gain.
Santana Moss, we're gonna see RG3 roll out to his left, and Santana Moss, he's not playing as much as he once did. They have younger receivers, but when they have a money down, they go to Santana Moss. Robert Griffin III told me last week, hey, when the game's on the line, that's the guy I'm going to. On fourth down, he finds his money receiver.
Caught his 500th career catch last week, said I'm not going to revel in it until the season is over. First down on the 29 of Minnesota. Here is the option, and it's going to be Griffin. And Griffin is stopped at the 21, and we have a penalty flag down. After a gain of 8.
Holding, offense, number 84. 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
So tight end Niles Paul, number 84, was holding, will nullify that 8-yard gain.
See Niles Paul on Chad Greenway, get his hand outside. It's that right arm, hold Chad Greenway, and you see it right there. Good call by the referee.
Greenway managed to make the play anyway. First down at 15. And here's the bubble screen for the Redskins. And it's to Banks. And Banks going out of bounds. The ball at the 31 of the Vikings.
Antoine Winfield, I tell you what, this guy's giving speeches, but more importantly, he's playing great football. Watch Antoine Winfield right here. Mentioned earlier how one of the better tackling cornerbacks in the history of this league throws a tight end out of the way, comes up, makes the play on Brandon Banks, having a big-time impact on this team.
You're right, he's playing an inspired football, knocking Niles Paul down. A bigger player, so second down and 15, no gain on the last play. And here's Griffin, and he goes out to the flat to Brandon Banks, and Banks is tackled. Good tackling by the Vikings there. It was Chris Cook, who is from nearby Lynchburg, Virginia, and having a good start this year. Picking up 2 yards on the play to Banks.
Dick, you mentioned it, and I think when I watch the Minnesota Vikings, I see the best tackling defense in all of football. The reason Alan Williams, their defensive coordinator, comes in and he preaches swarming to the football, playing smart football. They don't try to do too much. What they do extremely well.
Third down and 13. This is the 12th play of the drive. And there is the shovel pass. And Brandon Banks falls on it. The Vikings claiming they recovered it. Alfred Morris.
Be an incomplete pass.
Incomplete pass. And now shoving going on inside. Santana Moss and Jamarcus Sanford going at it.
Santana Moss, a fiery player. Bad things happen in those piles. I can tell you that from experience being under there. So someone did something that ticked him off. End result, though, a fourth down situation for Kai Forbath, the new kicker for the Washington Redskins.
This will be a 50-yard attempt And he is the 15th kicker in 12 years for this Redskin franchise. First regular season game in the NFL with a 50-yard attempt. Horvath kick is good. And a successful start for Kai Horvath, replacing Billy Cundiff as the place kicker for the Redskins, who trail the Vikings 9-3. Scoring drive, 13 plays, 48 yards. It's been all field goals thus far in the game. And there you see RG3, 5 for 6. Percy Harvin from the 2. Here's Harvin, crosses the 30-yard line and gets past the 35. And Harvin, who returned a kick 105 yards for a touchdown against Detroit. Vikings get it back and will be back. And Danny Smith couldn't be happier after that field goal. Percy Harvin on the sidelines, limped off the field after that kickoff return. Now the Vikings from the 36. In a 9-3 game, Ponder rolls out, and this pass incomplete, and a bit low for Kyle Rudolph.
We look at that last kickoff return, and Percy Harvin's going to get tangled up here with Darrell Young and D'Angelo Hall. It's that left leg he got up limping. The Minnesota Vikings can only hope. This guy is such an important part of that offense. And they're going to load the box on Adrian Peterson with Percy Harvin on the sideline.
Boy, he beats it so many ways. Two tight end formation. Adrian Peterson picking up a yard. Ryan Kerrigan making the tackle, and Harvin comes back on the field.
Comes back on the field, but does so gingerly. He's limping a little bit. And it, as we mentioned, I mean, he is so critical to this offense, because you see what they'll do. If they don't have him, Adrian Peterson becomes the only threat.
Third down and 9, and he lines up at the top to the right. Ponder looking right, and he completes the pass, and it's Adrian Peterson, and Peterson is stopped short by a yard by London Fletcher, who's done that throughout his career, makes the big stops before the first down, and a gain of 8 here.
And a nice job by Ponder. They're going to bring some pressure, try to confuse Christian Ponder. Always a good thing to get into the hands of Adrian Peterson. But what a play. What a play by London Fletcher as Adrian Peterson limps off the field.
So we have had Harvin and now Peterson limping off the field. And it was Lorenzo Alexander who very nearly got to Ponder. So Chris Cluey will be kicking it away, and Brandon Banks will be back deep for the Redskins. Fair catch. Banks lets it bounce, and it is down inside the 10 by Everson Griffin. 46-yard punt, and this was Peterson's run, and that got the great back lipping off the field. We'll take a timeout. And we're back here, and it'll be a first down at the 10 for the Redskins. And the pitch is to Alfred Morris. Good tackle made that time by Jasper Brinkley, and a short gain on the play. Well, two of the three impact players you talked about for the Viking offense, John, have been nicked early on here.
They've been nicked, but both these guys are tough guys. They'll be back in the game, but those guys go out, trouble for the Minnesota Vikings.
Leslie Frazier, normally a calm head coach, has some fire, and he was that as a defensive coordinator with this team. Second down and 7, and here's the pass caught, and it should be a first down. The flag goes down to Fred Davis, his third catch of the day, and we're going to have offensive pushing off offensive pass interference against the Redskins.
Pass interference, offense number 83. This penalty assessed half distance for the ball.
And it's on the tight end Banks for Davis.
See Mike Shanahan. I've seen that face before. You don't want to see that as a player. That's the angry Mike Shanahan, and he doesn't like lack of execution. Now they're executing well on the play, but you have a penalty. You can't have that against a defense like the Minnesota Vikings.
And you can't have that penalty when you're starting a drive from the 10. So half the distance, ball is at the 7. Second down and 13. Pressure, and the pass has gotten off to Morris. Alfred Morris, and Chad Greenway makes the tackle. Morris spinning his way out past the 15-yard line, gets 9 yards with Jared Allen very nearly getting to RG3.
Well, Jared Allen said, listen, I understand what's going on with RG3, but we hit quarterbacks, and that's what we do. You're going to watch Jared Allen get in and lay a hit on Robert Griffin, take him to the ground. Jared Allen, a terrific player. The sacks aren't there this year. Only 3 sacks for him. That's a slow start. But he is playing tremendous football per usual.
Third down and 4. Evan Royster, the third down back, is in there. And RG3's pass. And it's going to be a catch and a first down. Santana Moss in a crowd makes the grab and gets the first down just beyond the 20. And for another game, right?
Second. Picking John back to you.
Eli Manning playing some tremendous football.
Alfred Morris back in the game at running back. This is a play action pass, and this one is caught at the 35 by Leonard Hankerson. And a pickup of 14 yards.
Both these teams, because of their effectiveness in the running game, are great play action teams. You see Robert Griffin with the hard sell on the play action, throwing accurate football. That's the thing that I think I've been most impressed with on Robert Griffin, his accuracy throwing the football. He does it over and over again and does on that throw.
First down. And breaking the tackle is Alfred Morris. And Morris, tough runner to bring down. Gets 15 yards to midfield before Jamarcus Sanford, who started for Mistral Raymond, that strong safety, makes the tackle.
You think of all you have to deal with. You've got Alfred Morris, you've got Brandon Branks, and you've got Robert Griffin. What's that do? It creates indecision in the Minnesota defense, and you give a guy like Alfred Morris this much room. He showed the Atlanta Falcons last week with the tune of 115 yards. That he is no slouch at the running back position.
Biggest run of the day for the Redskins. And again, they go to Morris, but this time he's going to be stopped for no gain. 2 straight 100-yard gains for Alfred Morris. And a career high, 115. This is the 6th start of the year.
Go back to training camp. This was number 4 on the depth chart. And he said, I always knew I'd be a starter and I was going to make the most of my opportunity when I got it. He certainly has done that.
Second and 10 from midfield. Griffin. And the pass is caught by Santana Moss. And talk about yards after the catch. He gets a few down to the 20-yard line. Redskins with a 30-yard gain.
You know, and Santana Moss, I mentioned earlier, not playing the number of snaps he did last year. But with Pierre Garçon out today, he's getting his chance. Now, he's made the most of his opportunities. And I am venturing to say that Mike Shanahan's going to say, maybe we've written this guy off too early. Every time we put him out there, he makes plays. This is a pro's pro.
RG3 now with 110 yards passing. And there's the run by RG3. And a 7-yard gain on first down to the 13.
You look at this at the end of the play, live to play another down. That's a slide. That's not so much a tackle. He's getting by that, but he slides. He gets positive yardage, 8 yards. That's a good gain, and that's what Robert Griffin III is going to have to do.
Under 10 yards passing, 19 yards rushing, second down and 3. Griffin back close to the 30-yard line and throws this ball away. And now pointing that intentional grounding penalty.
Personal foul
roughing the passer. Aaron Henderson.
This just not a smart football play. And maybe a good dive by Robert Griffin, because Aaron Henderson doesn't do much there. He gets the Academy Award, so not easily a tremendous quarterback. He's a tremendous actor as well.
Did not look like it was it was a push. And I think RG3 made the most of it.
He sold that one hard.
Well, that's a big penalty there. Now it'll be first and goal at the 7-yard line. And the whistle, hand off to Morris.
Timeout, Washington.
And right before the snap, Mike Shanahan called a timeout. And that is the first timeout called by either team in this first half. 9-3, Minnesota timeout. Two quarters, two separate stories. And the Redskins looking to take the lead. First and goal at the 7. After a Washington timeout, here is Morris. And Morris is stopped at about the 2.5. Jasper Brinkley and then Antoine Winfield again. Winfield a big force here in the first half.
Now this looks like touchdown all the way, and this just goes back to the tackling of this Minnesota defense. Watch, out of nowhere, it's going to be Antoine Winfield and Jasper Brinkley come up for this tackle, and they hit Alfred Morris, and this does not happen with Alfred Morris. They hit him, he goes down. The hallmark of great defense is always his tackling. These guys do it as well as anyone.
Second and goal. Diving toward the goal line is Evan Royster. And he was stopped short of the goal line. And it was Everson Griffin who was in on the play.
Timeout, Minnesota. This is their first.
And the Minnesota Vikings call a timeout. Each team has two timeouts remaining, and we'll be right back. Third and goal, and Alfred Morris back in the game, John.
No, I wouldn't be surprised if they're using this guy, Alfred Morris, as a decoy right here. Play action situation, just got banged up on the shoulder. Wouldn't be surprised if it were play action.
And here is Morris going in for the touchdown. He didn't have far to run, but you've seen a situation like that for Mike Shanahan in the past, haven't you?
Yeah, I'm looking at it, and Alfred Morris hurt his shoulder. In the Super Bowl in 1997, I believe it was, Terrell Davis with migraines, and Mike Shanahan, they had audio on it. Hey, could you go in and just be a decoy for our play-action pass? But instead, it's Alfred Morris right up the middle. So that's a good option, too.
1 yard touchdown run by Morris, and that is his 5th touchdown of the season, capping a 90-yard drive. High four-back who connected on a 50-yard field goal, adds the extra point, and the Redskins take their first lead of the game, 10-9. Robert Griffin III back in action and leading the Redskins to the lead, and Morris giving him that lead with the touchdown. Drive, 11 plays, 90 yards for the touchdown, has gotten under Jared Allen's skin.
Jared Allen, always a fiery player. This defense takes a lot of pride. They don't like people going down the field. I don't think they like the penalty that extended the drive on Aaron Henderson, the roughing on RG3. But end result, though, 10-9 game for the Washington Redskins.
What a turnaround this quarter for Washington.
This game was being dominated by Minnesota. We'll see if Percy Harvin can change that.
Bobbles it in the end zone and will have to down it there. And his last return, lift off the field, and we saw Peterson do the same thing, but Peterson is coming out. 1 point, Washington. .27 remaining in the first half, and Talking about the Redskins reversing the first quarter dominance by the Vikings. Redskins have run 18 plays in the second quarter to only 3 for Minnesota.
This game really just a tale of two quarters. Minnesota dominant in the first one, and in the second one, Washington clearly taking over this game. We'll see if the Vikings can control the clock a little here and get some of that time of possession back in their favor.
Each team has 2 timeouts remaining. Ponder has completed 9 of 13 for 107 yards. So both of these young quarterbacks have gone over the 100-yard mark.
They may need to use Ponder more. They're loading the box. They're saying Adrian Peterson's not going to beat us after that first drive in particular. And they may need to let Christian Ponder take over.
He's shown this year that he can do that. Stepping up, and the ball is not loose, and it's picked up by Lorenzo Alexander. And a big break for the Redskins. Jim Haslett's defensive unit, he said, we want 3 turnovers, and he said, I want 3, and they've got 1 big one here.
I want you to watch Ryan Kerrigan up at the top of your screen. He's going to come in. It's actually Adrian Peterson. Perry Riley forces Adrian Peterson into Christian Ponder. Lorenzo Alexander, normally a special teams player, is there to make the interception. Washington has the ball going in.
And it's first and goal at the 6. Big break for the Redskins. Can they take advantage of it? And there's the pass. Darrell Young in for the touchdown. The Redskins have intercepted passes in 7 consecutive games going back to last season, and they got a big one here setting up this score.
Again, play action pass, Harrison Smith. You got to mind your luggage. His luggage was Darrell Young. Darrell Young slips out to the flat. Rookie mistake by Harrison Smith results in a touchdown for the Washington Redskins.
High four-back with the extra point. So a 6-yard touchdown pass from RG3 to Young, and 2 touchdowns 13 seconds apart. And the Redskins have taken a 17-9 lead with 2:14 remaining in the first half.
You go back to this turnover. Perry Riley going to come on Adrian Peterson, forces him as Ponder throws into Ponder's hand. And Lorenzo Alexander, as we mentioned, a special team standout. They're trying to find pass rush, and it results in a beautiful throw by RG3 to Darrell Young in the flat.
You know, John, with all of the Redskins' problems, they've given up 29 points a game, but they are +7 turnover ratio, which is amongst the league's best. And that really set up that score, and the fans in Washington who are despondent after the Nationals went down in that 5th and deciding game, as you mentioned, in the division series, have something to cheer about here.
They're alive right now, and I think you got to give a lot of credit to the defensive coordinator for the Washington Redskins, Jim Haslett. He's done a tremendous job with the loss of Brian Arakpo and Adam Carricker. They're finding themselves again as a defense.
And you talked about the numbers we just saw, how things have turned around dramatically for the Redskins in the second quarter. And here is Percy Harvin in the field of play on the return. And Harvin bringing it out to the 20. Well, Christian Ponder did not throw a pick in the first 4 games, but 3 in the last 2. Toby Gerhardt is the running back, and a play action to him. Ponder puts it down and will dive head first to the 30-yard line and get 7.5. And down to the 2-minute warning here at FedEx Field. Redskins were down 9-0, and they have come back in impressive fashion to lead 17-9, 2 minutes to play in the half. Two minutes remaining in the first half, and Ponder's pass, it's incomplete. intended for Kyle Rudolph, and the official scoring has changed that play that set up the last Redskin touchdown from an interception to a fumble. It was now ruled a fumble recovered by Lorenzo Alexander.
Whatever it was Washington's ball and resulted in a touchdown. And Minnesota now reeling. Big third down here for them.
Vikings were up by 9. Now they're down by 8. Third down and 3. Ponder, and the pass is caught by Harbin and a first down. Out to the 36, Jordan Pugh, former Carolina Panther, on the tackle after a gain of 6. Remember, the Vikings have 2 timeouts remaining. Winding now to 1.5 minutes to go in the first half. Pressure on Ponder, and he's going to flip it, but nothing doing to Adrian Peterson. As the Redskins, who have not been able to get pressure on opposing quarterbacks this year, doing a pretty good job now.
And they're doing it by creating confusion with scheme. Jim Haslett said, look, if we don't have the guys, we got to bring some stuff. This time it's Jordan Pugh who misses him, Perry Riley who comes. A great job by Christian Ponder actually getting the ball out. They're playing multiple players, Lorenzo Alexander in there, Keenan Robinson in there. They're playing a lot of different guys and realizing that we're going to have to scheme some things up because we don't have the players that right now could just one-on-one beat the Minnesota Vikings.
And, you know, John, they're also missing Brandon Merriweather, who has yet to play. The strong safety signed as a starter has a knee injury. So you have Merriweather, Arakpo, and Carricker out of there. It's a big bunch right there. So it's second down and 11. And 1 timeout remaining for the Vikings. Harbin. And Harbin will be a couple of yards short of the first down as Alexander makes the tackle from behind.
Those little screens are so effective with Harbin. Really, that's just a glorified run. Get the ball in his hands and make good things happen. And that's what he does on a consistent basis.
Minute remaining in the half. It'll be third down and 1. Ponder goes down, and it's Lorenzo Alexander. Stephen Bowen was also there. It'll be the second sack of the game for the Redskins. And now the Redskins will call a timeout, a loss of 9 yards as they envision getting the ball back and a chance to score some more points themselves.
Lorenzo Alexander, actually a captain of this team as a special teamer, he's saying, give me some more snaps on defense, Jim Haslett. And he's making his presence known.
49 seconds remain in the first half. And there is Brandon Banks. Chris Cluey will be kicking. Redskins have 1 timeout remaining. And looking for a good return. But a good kick. Great hang time, sending Banks back to inside his 10. And he is smothered at the 16-yard line. So halftime is coming up in a moment, and we have a penalty flag down. Okay. 56-yard punt.
During the kick, holding, receiving team number 35. This penalty assessed happiness and still a goal, first down.
So the penalty against David Jones.
Watch David Jones. They get him on a hold. I think both of them got a hold of Everson Griffin. That one's easy to call now. You got 2 guys, David Jones. Dejon Gomes pulling at that jersey of Everson Griffin.
First down for the Redskins on the 5. And they're going to accept their 8-point lead and take a knee. And that should be the last play of the first half as the players trot off the field. So Robert Griffin III suffering the concussion and cleared to play, getting tested all week. Coming up, the Visa halftime report with Kurt, Terry, Howie, Michael, and Jimmy, all scores and highlights. And we'll bring you up to date on what's going on in the NFL. And there's Lorenzo Alexander, who's a hero defensively. Well, we now go to Kurt Menefee in Los Angeles for the Visa halftime report, which... Favorite team all season long. Go to itunes.com/NFL. Well, a strong second quarter for the Redskins, John. And now the question is, how do the Vikings try to regain that momentum they had early on?
Well, I think what you got to do, you got to go back to your studs. And those are Adrian Peterson and Percy Harvin. But someone else is going to have to emerge. They're clearly making an effort to take those two out of the game. I think it's Kyle Rudolph. You got to find him some. And this defense got to start playing with the passion that they can and stop Robert Griffin. Robert Griffin's been incredibly effective. The Redskins clearly have momentum. We'll see if they can carry it over to the second half.
And the Redskins' defense played with passion in that second quarter as well.
They really did. I think you've got to credit this defensive staff led by Jim Haslett and the players. They're playing a lot of different guys, creating confusion, and really settled themselves down after a tough couple of series to start the game.
Well, right now, Harvin and Peterson are trying to do some furniture moving there on the side with the bench. And Peterson with 48 yards on 8 carries, averaging 6 yards a carry, had a 32-yard gain. And RG3, 11 of 14 for 116 yards and a touchdown and interception. Those are some of the individual stats. This is what the team stats look like. And you can see the contrast from the first and second quarter. Underway, the Redskins won the toss to first, and they get the ball to start the third quarter, and they'll get it out at the 20, and we send it down to Jennifer Hale.
Well, Dick, Coach Leslie Frazier tells me you will indeed see both Percy Harvin and Adrian Peterson in this second half. Although both are limping on their left legs, they'll play through, and Frazier says they'll be just fine. Coach Mike Shanahan tells me the thing he's most proud of his team, especially RG3, is how they kept their composure against those blitzes and when they were down early on. Dick?
All right, Jennifer, and of course, you got to be wary of that Viking defense, and they did a good job in fighting back. First down at the 20. Morris has 28 yards on 10 carries and a touchdown. And here is Morris bringing it out to the 23, picking up 3 yards on the first play of the third quarter.
One of the things that Jared Allen talked about is, hey, Leslie Frazier, that typically we see as a stoic guy on the sidelines, he had been our defensive coordinator. We know he has fire. Jared Allen went to him early in the year and said, we want to see that fire. And I think in this second half, Leslie Frazier is going to have to show you can be composed, but show some of that fire, because they got to get themselves back in this football game.
Got to get back on the defense to start it. Second down and 7, and breaking the tackle is Morris. And Morris will be stopped about a yard short of the 30-yard line by Antoine Winfield.
You watch the Washington Redskins run the football. There's enormous holes, and part of the reason you have to account for that guy, Robert Griffin, when you have to account for him and you have a runner like Alfred Morris and you have a zone scheme like Mike Shanahan and Kyle Shanahan implement that is always successful, it's going to be a bear to deal with, and that's exactly what it is.
Third down and 1, 2 for 6 on third downs thus far after the woeful 1 for 9, and here's the handoff, and second effort may have it for Alfred Morris. And let's see where they spot the ball. Kevin Williams made the tackle right away, and it looked like he might be short, but the second effort successful for Morris and a Redskin first down.
And that's great running, because Kevin Williams is in their backfield along with Chad Greenway, and he gets a little assist there from Chris Chester, his right guard, who pushes him forward for the first down. So second effort not only from Alfred Morris, a first effort from Chris Chester.
Alfred Morris's numbers thus far, and a first down at the 30. And there's the pass up the middle, and it's caught close to midfield by Josh Morgan. Morgan with his first catch of the day. And a first down out to the 47, picking up 17.
One thing I know that Mike Shanahan does as well as anyone for playing for him, you see the play action pass and the accuracy from Robert Griffin, is not only does he script to start the first 10, 15 plays, he scripts coming out of halftime. And right now, play action pass, running the football, they've clearly seen some holes in the Minnesota defense, and they're exploiting it.
And a first down, and there's the pass caught by Morgan again. So two receptions by Morgan on passes from RG3. This one gets 16 yards, and the Redskins are in Viking territory.
And it all fits together. We're going to see Josh Morgan's route. He's going up against a rookie, and Josh Robinson has space. Beautiful throw by RG3, but it's all running the football and then play action off the effective run game. And a very accurate and proficient Robert Griffin III.
Ready. And on first down, here is Morris, and the play is blown dead. And a penalty flag down. It should be going as a false start.
False start, offense, number 71. 5-yard penalty remains first down.
And that's on the left tackle, Trent Williams. And Williams going against Jared Allen. That's the matchup today for Williams, who has done pretty well.
Done a nice job. I mean, when you keep Jared Allen as quiet as he's been, you're doing something. And Trent Williams, last week it was John Abraham. This week, Jared Allen. You're talking about the two active sack leaders. Robert Griffin, you think his head's all right? I do. 13 to 16, 149 yards. He's been spectacular.
And this time the handoff to Morris. And Morris to the 38-yard line. And very crisp out there is RG3. And again, it was a kind of a week, no lingering effects. Tests were taken after every practice. Kyle Shanahan dialing up the plays for the Vikings. It'll be second down and 11.
Kyle Shanahan's done a tremendous job of dialing up plays for Robert Griffin all year long, utilizing different packages like this one with Brandon Banks, the wide receiver in the backfield. And
RG3 finds a receiver, and it's dropped. Desmond Briscoe was wide open, and Briscoe couldn't be more wide open, and he drops the pass.
Oh, and RG3, again, the play action, a little razzle-dazzle, and a perfectly thrown football. And Desmond Briscoe, plain and simple, you got to catch the ball. Active for the first time this year with Pierre Garçon's injury. You get your opportunities, you got to make the most of them. Tough when you haven't played, but you got to do it. It's the NFL.
So now third and 11. Santana Moss, who is the leading receiver with four catches for Washington, moves to the left slot. RG3 fakes the throw, will run it. And get it. He'll get the first down, and a flag is down.
Holding defense, number 52. This 5-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. First down.
So 15 yards plus 5, and Chad Greenway was holding.
And I tell you, someone who wasn't holding, this guy right here, he's doing a tremendous job on Jared Allen. This is a third and long situation that Jared Allen typically thrives, and there's just the all-out speed, and there's the smarts. Last week, maybe stay in bounds. This week, he's learned from his mistake, get out of bounds, live to see another play. And Trent Williams doing a wonderful job on Jared Allen thus far.
All of the action has been to that side of the field in the game, all of the scoring. Ninth play of this drive. Play action, and being chased from behind is RG3, and he's going to finally be dragged down by Harrison Smith. And a
horse collar
penalty is upcoming on Smith, who last week was ejected in the second quarter after shoving an official.
Personal foul, horse collar tackle, number 22 on the defense. This penalty will be assessed after the distance to the goal.
And it's tough. Harrison Smith, you're going for Robert Griffin, a guy with world-class speed, but you get your hand inside those shoulder pads and pull down. They're not going to miss that one. They'll call it every time. Robert Griffin's speed makes Harrison Smith lunge for him. Another penalty against the Minnesota Vikings.
So Smith, who was the number one pick out of Notre Dame, and after shoving the official, wasn't fined or suspended. It'll be first down and goal at the 7 for the Redskins. They've scored 2 touchdowns in this game. Perfect on the year and goal to goal, and still perfect. RG3 takes it himself for the 3rd touchdown of the game for Washington. 7-yard run.
RJ3 says, look, I'll be smart and I'll learn to slide and all that, but not when I'm down by the end zone. I'm going in the end zone. A designed run to RG3. Good block by Alfred Morris. And he stretches that ball across, and the fans appreciate it and let him know with the RG3 chant here in Landover, Maryland.
Now when he smells pay dirt, and the extra point by Forbath. And there is Griffin, who has thrown a touchdown pass, and he has run for one, and the Redskins up 24. NFL football here in Landover, Maryland, and his kick will be run out by Percy Harvin. Here's Harvin, past the 30, and hit and dropped after a good return by Chris Wilson. But RG3, the man of the hour, as the Redskins trying to end that long 8-game losing streak here at FedEx Field. 80 yards on 10 plays, and an all-round series for RG3. Meanwhile, the Vikings trying to get back in the game. They scored the first 9 points. The 24 unanswered by Washington. There's Ponder, and the pass is caught, but down he goes. And it's Adrian Peterson with the short gain. Game break time, Patrick. All right, thank you, Patrick. And the handoff after the 6-yard gain, and unable to get the first down is Peterson, but he comes pretty close. Perry Riley is there to make the tackle. Well, the Vikings offensive leaders, and their offense strictly was the first quarter deal. Ponder, Peterson, and Harvin.
And the percentage of that came in the first quarter, upwards of 80%. And you know, one thing that's killing the Vikings right now is not having Jerome Simpson. He is the deep threat on this team. The Redskins are stacking the box to stop Adrian Peterson. It's leaving one-on-ones outside, and they can't take advantage of it right now.
3rd down and 1, and here is Peterson. He gets the first down. So Adrian Peterson, who did have a 32-yard run in that first quarter.
And this is just good football right here. 3rd and short, straight ahead, behind the hammer, fullback Jerome Felton, and then 2 really good football players. A great one in Adrian Peterson, and a darn good one in London Fletcher, going head to head. Christian Ponder said, it seems like London Fletcher's been playing for 80 years and still playing at a high level.
And here's Peterson. Peterson edging his way to the 45-yard line, and it remains to be seen, John, whether we have any action in this game on the left side of this field, because all of the scoring have come from the right end. You know, those fans are feeling they're getting a little cheated here.
They want some down on this side. Vikings are going to try to give it to them.
2nd down and 4 on the 45 of the Redskins. And the pitch is to Adrian Peterson. Look at that great running by Peterson, picking his way and waiting for the openings to develop. He gets to the 39, and a 5-yard play and another Viking first down.
Now Adrian Peterson, primarily an inside runner, but he can go outside as well. Good job by Fusco, the offensive lineman, get out in front of him. But you can see the will of Adrian Peterson start to pay dividends. This guy just will not go down. See, the middle is where he does most of his work, but certainly can go outside when needed.
Toby Gerhard replaces it, giving the breather is Adrian Peterson, and here is Ponder's pass, incomplete, intended for the tight end Kyle Rudolph, the guy you said in halftime, and a valuable guy he's been, that they've got to go to more often.
Well, I think, as I mentioned, someone has to emerge, because the defense's attention is on 2 guys right now, 28 and 12. Adrian Peterson and Percy Harvin. That leaves one-on-ones for other guys. Kyle Rudolph's one of those guys who can take advantage of it.
Now Peterson is back in. Second down and 10. Play action. Ponder in trouble. And Ponder finds Aroma Shadu. And it'll be another first down. D'Angelo Hall makes the tackle. Good bit of ad-libbing by Christian Ponder with a 13-yard Viking pickup.
Well, a real nice job by Ponder extending the play. And then Aroma Shadu, you find the open area when your quarterback buys time. And Aroma Shadu is really a dependable guy, not a burner by any stretch. But Christian Ponder said, I always know where he's going to be. And he certainly did right there.
So Peterson out, Gerhardt in. Ponder 14 of 20 for 140 yards now. Ponder, and a flag is down, and the receiver, Percy Harvin, was down when the slam came in, and let's see whether Ryan Kerrigan is called for the push.
Pass interference, defense number 91, automatic, first down.
Look at right here. Ryan Kerrigan's one heck of a football player, but mismatched. 270 pounds going against 180. And Kerrigan tries to go with the muscle, but the referees get him as the ball was in the air. You've got to continue to change things up, but you do not want that matchup, Ryan Kerrigan on Percy Harvin. Now they got Harvin in the backfield.
And a first down on the 23, and Harvin's going to get the ball. And he is hit by London Fletcher. And holds Harvin to just 2 yards as we approach 5.5 minutes to go here in the third.
London Fletcher is playing an outstanding football game, making one-on-one tackles on Adrian Peterson, on Percy Harvin, hard to do. Looks easy on camera in slow motion. Live speed on that field, promise you, I've been there. That's a tough thing to do, and London Fletcher's doing it well.
Peterson in his tailbacks. Ninth play of the drive, he gets the call. And Peterson is hit right about the 20. And it was London Fletcher and another 2 yard gain. Vikings want to break the string of 24 straight points run off by the Redskins.
They're playing inspired football right now, particularly on defense.
Third and 6. Ponder looking downfield and overthrows Percy Harvin. And fourth down coming up, and it was Stephen Bowen who had 6 sacks last year. For the Redskins, their best from the defensive line, and now it'll be fourth down. And Blair Walsh, who kicked 3 straight first quarter field goals, in there now to try to reduce the margin. 37-yard attempt here. And Walsh, the rookie from Georgia, with the field goal, and it's now 24-12 Redskins. To download NFL Mobile now and get coverage of every NFL game. And that's the left knee of Percy Harvin, and bleeding as he goes out now is Harvin with 4 catches in the game. He's carried the ball twice, and the Redskins will start this possession out on the 20-yard line. Leading by 12, and RG3 coming back strong. Into this game is what would be the efficiency of RG3 after the concussion last week, when that has been answered emphatically. He has thrown for 149 yards, passed for 1 touchdown, rushed for 43, and has scored a touchdown. 192 total yards and a 12-point Redskin lead as they have a first down at the 20-yard line. And now we'll go out of bounds. After a gain of 2.
You know, Dick, when we talked to him the other day, he talked about against this Minnesota defense, 3 things. You got to be crisp, you got to be sharp, and you got to be firm. In everything I do, I've got to be decisive, because if you hesitate in this game against this kind of defense, it's bad things are going to happen. He's been all of that and more today. Incredibly sharp, incredibly firm, incredibly decisive, playing an outstanding football game.
And an important game in many ways for the Redskins. Second down and six. And here is RG3 on the carry, and he stopped 2 yards shy of the first down. The Redskins with a chance to get to 500. Now the Eagles lost to the Lions in overtime. And a victory for Washington will put them 3-3, Philly at 3-3.
Leslie Frazier said the hardest thing is that these guys run the option. Not necessarily an option there, fake the dive, but then there's always that option of RG3 carrying the football. Sets up a very manageable third down situation.
The Giants leading big against the 49ers, could go to 4-2. Dallas lost. And there is the run by Robert Griffin Jr., third, I should say, and he gets the first down. Antoine Winfield makes the tackle, and he gets 5 yards. He answered the questions today. This is the last drive.
I'd say so. Talk about being sharp, being firm, being decisive. Robert Griffin's done that. Alan Williams, the defensive coordinator, after the last play said, forget about his headache. He gives me a headache because we've got to prepare for so much when you face a quarterback like Robert Griffin III.
Washington first down. RG3. Open is Fred Davis. And Davis pushed out of bounds and another first down to the 48-yard line. So chalk up 15 more for the Redskins, and they are rolling after falling behind early 9-0.
Some of the things Robert Griffin III does are far beyond his years. We can talk about the athleticism, but the moxie, the smarts. On the last play, he's pumping downfield, making the Vikings think he's going downfield. What's he do? He drops it off, but the space is created because he sells that he's going down the field. Not only a very athletic and talented player, a very smart player.
And here's the pitch to Morris. Tough runner showing it there, and the flag is down. Greenway makes the tackle after a pickup of 5.
Holding, offense number 83. 10-yard penalty, repeat, first down.
Fred Davis, the tight end, holding. And that will move the ball back into Washington territory. Mike Shanahan trying to get out of here with a victory with two tough road games coming up against the Giants and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Trying to get to 500. And if he does, the worst they'd be would be a game behind the lead in the division. RG3 incomplete, going to Fred Davis. And it'll be second down and long, second and 20.
And Dick, this is just a critical juncture of this game for the Minnesota Vikings. You're down 2 scores, a lot of time left. But you allow them to get points, even a field goal, back to a 3-score game. Critical and pivotal point for the Minnesota Vikings defense. And a real good time. If I'm a player, if I'm Harrison Smith, Jared Allen right now, I'm saying time for me to take over this game.
Well, the Redskins have touchdowns on their last 3 possessions, not counting the kneel down at the half. Second down and 20, trying to get some of it back. And this pass is caught by Leonard Hankerson. And Hankerson makes the catch at the 45. Still with a long way to go for the first down. They got 9 yards here. How about this on third down conversions? They were 0-for-4. Early on, and they've been perfect in their last 5, and 56% for the game.
Robert Griffin III calmly the other day when we talked to him, he said, I'm not stressed about it. We're not stressed about it. We need to execute better. And they're clearly doing that.
Third down and 11. RG3 pointing and will go out of bounds, won't get the first down. So the pressure by Jared Allen pays off for the Vikings. And will force the Redskins to punt with 39 seconds remaining in the third.
They don't get the first down there, and Jared Allen shows what he always does, relentless pursuit of the football. But I go back again to the job that Trent Williams, the left tackle, they haven't given him a ton of help over there in the run games, the help they've given him, but when asked to protect Jared Allen, he's done it.
Sam Rocca will be kicking. Marcus Sherrills will let this ball bounce, and it's caught down by the Redskins inside the five. Great hustle by Niles Paul, and he's going to make Ponder and Company go a long way. Remember them? This could be the last play of the third quarter. Starting from the 4-yard line of the Vikings. Handoff is to Adrian Peterson, and it's Rob Jackson. Not much there, and that will do it. As Jackson and Wilson have handled things with a rat pull-out. That's the end of the third quarter, 24-12 to score. America's Game of the Week returns after these messages and a word from your local Fox station. And the Redskins have outscored the Vikings 24-3 since the first quarter. It'll be second down and 8, and this crowd on its feet to make it tough for the Viking offense. Pass is caught by Rudolph, and Kyle Rudolph comes out of it with a first down to the 17. So they get out of trouble there. Redskins have allowed only one play of 10 or more yards since the first quarter, the 13-yard pass, and now another 13-yard pass.
This Redskin defense has been very good, Dick, and Jim Haslett deserves a ton of credit because he's been looking for the right mix since Arakpo and Carricker went out. He hasn't found it. He found it today.
From the 19, first down. At the 10-yard line, Ponder doesn't find a receiver and slides. And for a game break, Giants making a round of it so far on the road. Second down and 10, and the handoff is to Peterson. And Peterson just gets a few. 3 yards, and Jarvis Jenkins, defensive end, number 99, is there. So it'll be third and long coming up for Christian Ponder and the Vikings.
And you just continue to see massive substitutions. Jim Haslett, Mike Shanahan throwing different combinations, trying to confuse Christian Ponder and this Minnesota Vikings defense.
On third and 7, a flag.
False start, illegal snap on the center. 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
That one is on John Sullivan.
Leslie Frazier said, look, you're coming on the road. You've got to play a clean game. No penalties, no turnovers. And they've had a lot of penalties and the one big turnover. See Sullivan move the ball early. Illegal snap. Tony Corrente right on it.
And Leslie Frazier, John, knew that this would be a passionate team he'd be playing that had lost 8 straight home games. Third down and 12. Ponder throws the interception, picked off by Medeal Williams. Williams to the 5. A touchdown, he gets over. Medeal Williams coming over from the 49ers, but played 3 years with the Vikings with a 24-yard interception return for the touchdown.
You're going to see Ponder buy time and then just a bad overthrow. Looking for Michael Jenkins, throws it right to Medeal Williams. Jim Haslett, when we asked him to win, what do you got to do? He said, we need 3 turnovers. They're to 2. We'll see if they can get to 3, but it's working pretty good.
And checking all turnovers and scoring plays on replay. So Medeal Williams gets a little revenge on his former team. And Kai Forbath, the new kicker, who has been perfect today and started the Redskins scoring when they were down 9-0 with a 50-yard field goal. And Jim Haslett's inspired defense forcing Ponder into a big mistake. It's now 31-12 Redskins. And a joyous crowd here at FedEx Field. And Medeal Williams basking in the glow of the interception and return for the touchdown. A defensive touchdown for the Redskins, giving them a 31-12 lead. And Harbin We'll see that kick bounce out of the end zone, and the Vikings will start at the 20. Well, a contrast in mood so evident here. In this game, Leslie Frazier has seen better, that's for sure. Not today, though. This is an oddity right here. Redskins 0-3 when scoring a defensive touchdown, but they have just scored their fourth defensive TD of the season. And leading here 31-12. Vikings from the 20. Under pressure on him, and he gets it off to Rhett Ellison, and Ellison will pick up the first down with the play made out to the 36, 16-yard gain, and the crowd quieted right now. Early here in the fourth quarter, Dick Stockton along with John Lynch and Jennifer Hale.
Real good composure by Christian Ponder. You see the blitzing Redskins coming after him. He buys time, finds Ellison for a big game, the biggest in a long time for the Minnesota Vikings.
First down, Ponder lost this one and overthrows John Carlson. He had Carlson as a target on the left side, so it'll be second down and 10. And
we've talked about Robert Griffin III being an accurate passer coming in today, leading the league, only a little percentage point behind Christian Ponder second, and 69%. Hasn't been as accurate as he had been coming in today. Missed a couple open targets, most notably the last one where he hit Medea Williams, who's on the other side.
RG3 is 15 for 20. Second down and 10. Ponder drills it, and the pass is caught by Harvin. Percy Harvin, with defenders right with him, with pressure on Rob Jackson on Ponder, completes a 20-yard pass. And now limping off again is Harvin.
When in doubt, go to your studs, and Percy Harvin certainly is that. And yes, they're going to garner attention, but the great ones find a way to get open, even when everybody else knows they're going to try to get open. And Percy Harvin's a great one.
Vikings in Redskin territory at the 44, and here is Adrian Peterson breaks a tackle and bulls his way to within 8.5 yards before Riley makes the stop. And Harvin is going to come back in. Meanwhile, Peterson has gained 79 yards rushing. Harvin has 5 catches for 73 yards to lead his team.
Harvin was going in, and his wide receiver coach, George Stewart, great wide receiver coach up there in Minnesota, pulls him off.
And the tight end Carlson is wide to the left. In motion is Rudolph on second down and 2. Ponder up the middle and bobbled. And Redskins indicate incomplete, and it is an incompleted pass to Kyle Rudolph. And that will bring up 3rd and 2.
You talk about anomalies. Kyle Rudolph dropping a football. This guy has tremendous hands. He snatches the ball. I think some of the best hands in the NFL. Drops a pass right there. Puts the Vikings in a big third down.
And you have games like that. Toby Gerhardt has checked in. 3 wide receivers to the right, including Harvin in motion. And this is the bubble screen to Harvin. He gets the first down to the 30-yard line. And 6-yard gain and another first down into Redskin territory further.
You see Ryan Kerrigan, who picked off one of those last week versus the Atlanta Falcons. But again, all that is a glorified run. You get the ball in your stud Percy Harvin's hands and let him do the rest of the work. And I keep doing it until they take it away, because every time he touches it, good things happen.
Well, he's touched it, caught 6 passes for 79 yards. Adrian Peterson checking back in, and he gets the handoff, and he slips, no gain. With under 10 minutes to go in the fourth quarter, and you can see Peterson a bit upset with himself as he slipped on the handoff. He's averaged nearly, or more than, 5 yards per carry.
Most of it coming on that initial drive of the game where he was so successful. Adrian Peterson, we said, where are you still lacking? He said, my strength's not all the way back in the left leg. And again, I'd say, can't tell.
Second down. This one is caught by Rudolph. Kyle Rudolph gets another first down for the Vikings. Josh Wilson, the cornerback, making the tackle. 16 yards to Rudolph, and he managed to hold on to that one.
And you see, with so much emphasis, I keep going back to it, with so much emphasis on Harbin, so much emphasis on Adrian Peterson, other guys are going to be open. And Kyle Rudolph's a guy who's got to start making people pay when they want to leave him wide open.
Rudolph, three catches today. Here's Harbin, first down. Harbin. And Harbin getting inside the 10. D'Angelo Hall grasped him, but not before a 5-yard gain. And the Vikings moving impressively here.
You see right here, they're going to try to use Harbin as a decoy on the quick screen and throw to Aroma Shadu. D'Angelo Hall on it, so dump it off to Harbin. And again, he makes something happen. A lot going on there in that play. And Percy Harbin so valuable as a player, also as a decoy.
10th play of the drive coming up. Second down and 5. And this one is caught by Michael Jenkins. And Jenkins, no signal. It is a touchdown for the Vikings. 9-yard pass to Jenkins, and Minnesota comes back on an impressive drive.
Really nice job extending the football. They got the right call. Touchdown. I think that will be confirmed. See if his feet are in. Yeah, left foot in. Stretches the ball out. A really nice answer by Christian Ponder. After the interception, comes right back. Now they're going to go for two here, are the Vikings.
First touchdown catch by Jenkins this year. And here is the two-point conversion. Vikings are 2-for-2 on two-point conversions this year. And this pass will be... Did he keep both in? Yes! Rudolph! Kyle Rudolph! Yes! Perfect on the year. And both feet in. And the two-point conversion here on a touch pass from Christian Ponder, and the Vikings coming back, now trailing by 11. And welcome back to FedEx Field. And there is Brandon Banks back deep. It's 31-20 with 8:02 remaining. Blair Walsh. And the Redskins will take out at the 20-yard line. Here's Michael Jenkins. And Rudolph, who was a basketball player of the year in high school. A lot more, the World Series. Redskins, Giants, Eagles, Falcons. Here's the pass out to Brandon Banks. And Banks hit by Jamarca Sanford. Preparing the quarterbacks today. Both have thrown one touchdown and one pick.
The numbers look similar. RG3 with the 63 rush yards and the touchdown running. But he clearly has outplayed Christian Ponder. Ponder looked very impressive in that last drive. We'll see what he has left. He plays well in the fourth quarter.
But Ponder does look a lot more comfortable this year than he did in his rookie year, when he was the 12th pick out of Florida State. And the Redskins will call a timeout. It's their first of the second half. Very difficult game for Everson Griffin, mourning the death of his mom. For more, let's go down to Jennifer Hale.
Mom dying suddenly while visiting him earlier this week. Griffin found out the news while in the locker room. His teammates were the ones that rushed him home. He says he's playing here tonight because his mom would tell him, don't you let those guys down. Everson tells me he feels good about being here, though, because he can feel her spirit out here with him tonight on the field. Dick.
Thank you very much, Jennifer, and all of the Vikings consoled to the best they could Everson Griffin, Sabrina Scott, his mom. Redskins with second down and 10. RG3 completes the pass to Josh Morgan. And Morgan, close to the first down, just a bit shy, gets 9 yards.
The Washington Redskins just Percy Harvin'd the Minnesota Vikings defense. They're going to hide Josh Morgan, and boom, across the formation he comes. You get the ball to him. Really a nice play by Jamarcus Sanford. Probably his responsibility, but the hustle sets up a third down. You give yourself a chance with hustle like that by Jamarcus Sanford.
And if you're the Vikings, proud of your defensive improvement this year, third down and one, this would be an important stop for them. And the pitch to Morris. He's backtracked and tries the second and third effort, and the Vikings managed to get that stop on third and one, and there'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play, and the Redskins will have to kick.
And I want you to see two things. First of all, the penetration by, I believe, Brian Robinson, and then the swarming to the football. That's what great defenses do. They get to the football. It's Aaron Henderson and Robinson that blow it up. Harrison Smith misses him, but here comes the posse. Good defense by the Minnesota Vikings.
So Sav Rocca will be kicking from inside the 15, and Marcus Sherrills running up, and Sherrills gets hit and loses his helmet in the process. What a hit put on by Niles Paul.
Wow.
But the Vikings will get the ball back. Sherrills held on to the ball. Sherrills on the left, Niles Paul on the right, who delivered that crunching hit that sent Sherrills' helmet flying. Paul just earlier had downed a punt inside the five for the Redskins. So we know what he can do special teams-wise. Meanwhile, 6:18 to go in the fourth. First and 10 for the Vikings. Two-possession game right now. And an incomplete pass to Rudolph.
This is the kind of inspired play. Just take a listen. Take a listen and take a look. Helmets flying. The Redskins playing inspired football. And Danny Smith, the special teams coach, comes over and says, attaboy.
So the Vikings have to fight from behind there to extend their winning streak to 4 in a row, coming in at 4-1 on the year. Second down and 10. And the pass is out to Percy Harvin. And Harvin, and a high tackle made there by David Jones after a gain of 9. Very close to the first down, out to the 42.5.
And I tell you what, an excellent tackle, because if he doesn't make that tackle, Percy Harvin is gone. He's hitting his head on the goalpost. David Jones getting his first action of the year, makes a crucial third down, tackle, setting up a third down for the Redskins.
Former Jaguar Leslie Frazier, who had his first career win as a head coach against the Redskins right here, has his team off to the hot start at 4-1, tied with the Chicago Bears. They are short by about the length of a football on third down.
Look at this clock, Dick. We got an 11-point game, 5 minutes and 50 seconds, plenty of time. Got to get points. Remember, it doesn't matter whether you get the touchdown or field goal, because you're going to need both at some point. But you got to get the ball down in territory for Blair Walsh, their kicker, to have an opportunity at least.
Trying to run for it, and he does get the first down. Christian Ponder on the bootleg gets the first down for the Vikings.
And they get the first down, but watch Kyle Rudolph right here. Reed Dowdy, the strong safety on him, he's trying to get out. Reed Dowdy does a nice job of holding effectively, let's just say that, hands inside so the referees don't see it. But Ponder athletic enough, and that's one attribute he brings. Not as athletic as Robert Griffin, but this kid's a fast kid, about 4'5 in the 40, and he has used it to make many plays this year.
Carried 3 times, has gained 11 yards. First down out of the shotgun, and Ponder, surrounded by burgundy jerseys, goes down. They'll credit Ryan Kerrigan with the tackle after a gain of 2, and now we have under 5 minutes remaining. 31-20, the Redskins lead, 2-possession game, and the hurry up for Minnesota.
Vikings starting to feel the urgency of the clock.
this is ruled a catch, and it would be a first down for the Vikings. Michael Jenkins, who caught the touchdown pass.
I don't think much of a question. We'll see Jenkins, both hands underneath, controls the football. Good call, good catch by Jenkins.
Jones signaling right away. No, he doesn't have it. So it's a first down for Minnesota, and this pass thrown over the head of Harbin, and Medeal Williams was in the neighborhood over there, but it's out of bounds, and it's now second and 10.
Jim Haslett and this defense have done such a nice job of mixing up coverages. Remember, Christian Ponder felt like that's maybe where they were a little vulnerable. You do so much, you can't be good at all of it. They have been today.
Ponder is 23 for 35 for 242 yards, one TD and one pick. Second and 10 in Redskin territory. At the 45. They swing it out to Adrian Peterson. Peterson gets the first down and a couple of jukes, and he gets inside the 30. And Williams finally brings him down, and the Minnesota Vikings moving the ball, and there's a Redskin player shaken up on the field after the gain of 18. And it's Jordan Pugh, the safety, shaken up with 3:53 remaining in the fourth. And the Redskins up by 11. We'll be right back. And Jordan Pugh heading into the locker room, replaced by DeJohn Gomes, shaken up on the field. So it'll be first down for the Vikings. Leading two scores here. Pressure up the middle on Ponder. Ponder going deep into the end zone and incomplete. There's the flag. Devin Aromashadu with two defenders, Medeal Williams and Josh Wilson, both back there. And a late flag and a pass interference penalty. And this crowd stunned.
Pass interference, defense number 26 with early contact. As a foul occurred in the end zone, the ball gets placed at the 1 yard line. Automatic first down.
We'll put it at the one as Josh Wilson interfered in the end zone.
I want you to look, all this pressure in front, up front. That means one-on-ones outside. Ponder takes advantage of it. I don't know, it doesn't look like a whole lot going on out there. He extends that left arm, I guess, but the result, Vikings ball.
Might have pushed him with that left hand. Here's Ponder, first and goal, flips it into the end zone to Rudolph for the touchdown. And the Vikings taking advantage of a pass interference penalty. And a 1 yard pass from Ponder to Rudolph. That was a 27-yard penalty setting up this score.
See the hard play action. Adrian Peterson, such a weapon. Even when he doesn't get the ball, a wide open Rudolph. And now you go for two to try to make it a three-point game.
They're perfect three for three, including one already in this game on a two-point conversion. And here is Ponder, and he flips it, and incomplete. Rudolph claims that he was hit by Perry Riley, but no flag down. And so the two-point conversion fails, and the lead is five for the Redskins.
It's Kyle Rudolph working on Perry Riley, tries to get open. Riley has that left hand on him, but if you aren't tugging him, they let him play there. Now the Vikings have to make a stop and have to go down and score a touchdown.
Well, the last two possessions for the Vikings have resulted in touchdowns. They went 80 yards with Jenkins catching the pass, and now 67 yards with Rudolph making the grab. Couldn't get the two-point conversion. So with 3:36 to go in the fourth, it's 31-26 in favor of Washington. The Redskins, who have gotten a fantastic game from RG3 and 245 yards rushing and passing.
Dick, you remember timeouts, three of them for Minnesota. Not a big issue is the time for Minnesota. They have to make a stop.
Stay tuned after the game for the OT presented by Lowe's, followed by game one of the NLCS between the St. Louis Cardinals and the San Francisco Giants. Those are the last two world champions in baseball, and they'll square off for the right to go into the World Series.
These Vikings are starting to look like the St. Louis Cardinals in baseball, hanging in there. And Washington fans on the edge of their seats.
Cardinals were down to the last strike twice. And the Vikings were down 24-9. And this kick and sails out of the end zone. And right now for a game break, let's check in with Patrick O'Neill.
Yeah, Dick, you guys are
in the division series against Madison Bumgarner. And there is RG3, and he's going to be enveloped by Jared Allen. And the first sack of the game for the Vikings and for Allen, his fourth of the season.
Jared Allen, one of the things that makes him so special is that he's relentless. Trent Williams is doing a tremendous job all day. Now you try to put a tight end, Logan Paulson, on him, and Jared Allen's going to have none of that. Over 100 sacks in his career. That's his fourth of this year. He says you sack a quarterback with your feet. You put your feet where he is, and he does it to RG3.
Loss of four, and here's the pitch to Alfred Morris. And the big back brings it out to the 24. LaTroy Guyon making the tackle. And now the Minnesota Vikings call their first timeout.
One thing that has become a hallmark of this Vikings defense is pursuit to the football. Watch the pursuit. Great block by Trent Williams on Chad Greenway. Ragdolls him. But it's LaTroy Guyon and Kevin Williams, the two defensive tackles. That's hustle. That's effort. That's want to by the Vikings and LaTroy Guyon.
2:56 remaining in the fourth quarter. And in case you've joined us, Robert Griffin III has thrown for 182 yards, 63 rushing yards, two touchdowns total. Remember, he suffered a concussion last week, came back Wednesday, was cleared to play, and he's been outstanding since the first quarter. Vikings led 9-0. Washington scored 24 unanswered points. Tough game here, and here is RG3. He's going to run for the first down, and still on his feet. RG3 is going to outrace everybody. Point 76 yard touchdown run by RG3.
I mean, are you kidding me? What a call, first of all, by Kyle Shanahan. That's a designed run. That's a designed quarterback draw. And that right there, ladies and gentlemen, that's world-class speed by Robert Griffin III. Speed this NFL has never seen. And that was a world-class block by Josh Morgan. What a play by Robert Griffin III. All-out speed, coming off a concussion last week, but playing tremendously and leading the Washington Redskins today. He's even put a little high step out there.
And just looking over his shoulder, RG3. The Washington Redskins are 2 minutes and 43 seconds away from snapping an 8-game home losing streak. At the old RFK, the Redskins rarely lost, but they've lost 8 in a row. And their last victory was in the second game of the regular season last year when they defeated the Arizona Cardinals 22-21. They have lost 8 straight. And today on the brink of snapping it.
Dick, our booth is right next to Daniel Snyder, the owner for the Redskins. And he just gave me, I think he likes his investment.
And this kick fielded by Harvin. They'll start at the 20, and if you think this is not a bad way to unleash it, John.
They won't soon forget Robert Griffin. 12 rushes, 139 yards. Are you kidding me?
There is Ponder, and this pass is caught, getting away. Harvin spinning away from a defender, gets in up to the 42-yard line. So Percy Harvin, and Wilson is down. Josh Wilson shaken up for the Redskins after the 22-yard play. So Pugh earlier went off, and now Wilson is shaken up for a Redskin defense that has really taken a punishment this year.
Tell you, Percy Harvin's one of those players that every time he gets the ball, you hold your breath because he looks like he can go the distance. He's stretching out that calf on the sidelines. Josh Wilson, I think, takes Percy Harvin's heel right in his gut. Watch at the end of this play, Josh Wilson get in. Trainer's looking at Wilson.
So Wilson may be helped off the field. Meanwhile, Percy Harvin has caught 9 passes for 115 yards, but it's RG3's day, and the Redskins looking to even their season record at 3-3. Eagles lost today to go to 3-3, and the Giants with a 20-point lead with a couple of minutes left, and they would take the division lead with a 4-2 mark. Dallas lost. They're 2-3. So anytime he can stay in the race, John Lynch, it's a fruitful day.
Absolutely. The Redskins are doing that. As you mentioned, here come the Giants next week. They got to finish this one first, though. We still got a lot of football.
First down. Ponder swings it out to Adrian Peterson. And he'll get a couple of more yards before he goes out of bounds to stop the clock. Let's check it. All right, Patrick, thank you very much. Second down and one. Toby Gerhardt is in the game, but Ponder is going to try to throw, and it's going to be Lorenzo Alexander. How about Alexander, who recovered a fumble to set up a Redskin touchdown? He gets Ponder and a loss of 8 yards. 2 minute warning here at FedEx Field, and the Redskins with impact on both sides of the ball big time today. Downs engineered by RG3, over 200 yards passing and rushing. And the 76-yard spectacular run through the middle of the line and then to the sideline at Olympic-type speed without question, John Lynch. Third down and 9 with 2 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. Pass is caught by Harvin. And Harvin will stop the clock and get out of bounds. And a first down for the Vikings, who are down by 12.
You know, Dick, I'm studying this week, looking at all the Vikings film, and I keep thinking my iPad I watch my film on is stuck in fast forward because every time Percy Harvin has the ball, it looks like he's in fast forward. That's real speed, folks.
Well, 10 passes for 126 yards. Big game for Harvin. Josh Wilson is back in the game for the Redskins, by the way, and Kyle Rudolph makes the reception and goes out of bounds, and the clock stops with 1:45 remaining. Want to remind you, after the game, it'll be the OT presented by Lowe's, followed by game one of the NLCS between the St. Louis Cardinals and the San Francisco Giants. Second and 7, the Vikings do have 2 timeouts remaining.
But there's got to be some urgency. They got to get the ball downfield.
And you know the Redskins are expecting that as well. So they go underneath, and the pass is caught by Jenkins. First down, and stops the clock at 1:38. But it's a 2-possession game at this point. 10-yard gain.
This is tough duty for Christian Ponder. Got to keep moving the chains, but as you mentioned, the Redskins know time's on our side. We can sit back, let you throw in front, 1:38 left. Two timeouts left for the Vikings. Got to score two touchdowns.
And again, they go underneath to Michael Jenkins once more. And close to the first down. And it looks like another 10-yard pickup and a timeout will be called by Minnesota. That'll be their second.
Minnesota.
RG3 has been phenomenal. And looked like he wanted to stay in the crowd with those fans. And he has really done a number against Jared Allen and the rest of the Minnesota Vikings, who had given up an average of 11 points a game in the last three, and now 38 put up by the Redskins today.
And I think that look from Jared Allen was a little bit of being tired, chasing Robert Griffin III, and a little bit of amazement of what this kid just did to him. And defensive coordinators are going to have to try to figure this guy out for a long time to come.
Short of the first down by less than a yard, Ponder throwing it away. And it'll be third down and about a yard with 1:26 on the clock.
Jim Haslett continues to spin the dial. Sometimes blitz, sometimes rush three. The blitz came right there. He's been unpredictable all day. I think it's called a brilliant game.
And if they can hold on, a huge game for the Redskins to break the losing streak at home, knowing they've got the Giants and Steelers on the road the next 2 weeks.
It's been since last September since they've won at home.
Now third and one. And they, of course, have two downs to get the first down. Here is Ponder, plenty of time. And this pass intended for Jenkins. And fourth down and less than a yard.
Ponder knows he has to take his shots down the field. But right now, you got to worry about converting the first down. But time, really an issue now. 1:20 left, only one timeout left for the Vikings.
Vikings missed a chance for a two-point conversion on their last touchdown. Would have made it a field goal, but it's a moot point, considering what RG3 did, running for 76 yards and a score. So it's fourth down and one. Ponder's pass. And it is caught by Jenkins in a first down. It keeps the Vikings alive as we wind down to a minute remaining in the fourth.
They understand the urgency, does Christian Ponder. We got to move, guys. We got to move right now.
Ponder again. And this pass caught by Rudolph. And he makes the catch and goes out of bounds again with one tick under a minute to go. Picked up 5 yards.
If I'm Washington, having been here before as a player, I'm saying, you remember the line from Hoosiers, the picket fence? You just set up a picket fence on that goal line. You're not getting in here. Catch anything you want in front. You're not getting in this goal line.
And that's the way they're lining up. And the crowd at that end of the end zone trying to be a factor. Here's the slant, incomplete to Jenkins. And it'll be third down and five.
There's that picket fence. Jordan Pugh lines himself on the goal line. Says, all right, if you're going to catch it, you're going to pay. Puts a hit on, and Michael Jenkins drops it.
So Pugh twice has been shaken up in this game.
Good clean hit, lowers his target, puts his shoulder right on the ball. Nice play by Jordan Pugh, but I think he comes up a little woozy.
And the Redskins using their second timeout here. Well, week two of last season, the Redskins rallied in the fourth quarter with Rex Grossman hitting Santana Moss for a touchdown and Graham Gano picking the go-ahead field goal. There's Gano. Arizona had a final shot to win it, but the defense came up with a turnover right here to preserve the victory. Last time, the Redskins won a home game. They have lost their last eight, longest active streak in the NFL and the third longest streak in franchise history, and 54 seconds away from breaking all of that. And the Redskins, by the way, timeout was mandated because of an injury in the last 2 minutes of the game. So now third down and five for the Vikings. They have one timeout left. And they need two scores. Here's the pass to Harbin. And Harbin is stopped a yard short of the goal line. That's just going to hurt them with the time.
Absolutely. You got to get up to the ball, and you got to go right now. Get this ball in the end zone.
Ponder's throw tipped. Incomplete. Second and goal for Minnesota. They give it to Adrian Peterson. A flag goes down. Peterson is in. But let's check the penalty from Tony Corrente.
False start, offense, number 82, with the flinch. 5-yard penalty.
Kyle Rudolph.
Second down.
It's Kyle Rudolph right there. But as Leslie Frazier said, to win on the road, you've got to be clean. No penalties, no turnovers. They've had both. They've had plenty of both, and it's hurt them.
And John, 15 penalties today. That's not the recipe that Leslie Frazier had for his team. It's taken him a while when they got very close to score. Second and goal here, and this pass is caught by Peterson at the four. Medea Williams, who has an interception and return for a touchdown.
Minnesota, this is their third
against his former team, and the Vikings will call their third and final timeout of the game. Wild game. And we didn't know what we were going to see from RG3, John. We came in, we knew that they said that he was cleared to play after the concussion. And what a performance for him today.
It's been spectacular. And the Vikings, they fought hard to get themselves back in this game. First, let's go back. The Redskins fought hard to get back in the game after the Vikings came out hot. But both teams kept playing, but RG3 proved too much at the end. That 76-yard run on a big third down, absolutely unbelievable has his effort been. And I tell you what, this defense has been pretty darn good as well.
Yes, and they've shredded the Viking defense. And here is Ponder, and he loops it in, and it's intercepted by D'Angelo Hall, and you can put an exclamation point on this game.
And there's Jim Haslett's third turnover. To get a win, we need three turnovers. He just got it.
He says two things, tackling, which they got, and three turnovers, which they just got. And with 22 seconds to go, you can see the look on the faces of these Redskins, who finally break the losing streak here at home. And for the Minnesota Vikings, their three-game losing streak comes to an end. And they go to 4-2 on the season. Redskins will be even at 3-3. So Mike Shanahan's team beats a good team here. The Giants in Pittsburgh on the road. And then before the bye, Carolina Panthers. And then you have three division games before a tough game here against the Ravens. And so the Washington Redskins defeat Leslie Frazier and the Minnesota Vikings. As Shanahan and Frazier meet at midfield, but it was all RG3 show today. We'll return to Washington to wrap up today's game after these messages.